Bakker of the Naturopath, thanks for coming back. I often get asked questions about the ileocecal valve. People with all sorts of gut problems, they get tenderness and pain in this region. So for those of you who don't know, whoops, look at that, my belly button's coming out. So those of you who don't know where the ileocecal valve is, well, if we look at the belly button about here and we look at the right hip bone on this side and we sort of go about midway here, the ileocecal valve's going to be around here somewhere, isn't it? So many people can feel a bit of tenderness around this region, especially people who've got SIBO, all right, small intestinal bowel issues, but also people with all kinds of digestive problems can have ileocecal valve issues. So what is the ileocecal valve? Well, there are three sections to the small bowel and one major section to the large bowel, okay? We've got the ileum is the terminal part, or the piece right at the end of the small intestine, and it connects to the cecum, okay? Basically the beginning part of the large intestine. So it comes right down, okay, stomach, all the way through the small bowel, up to that valve area, the ileum, where it joins up. And there's basically a one-way valve connecting the ileum with the large intestine. And that's to stop backflow. So that valve is only open at brief periods of time, of course, to allow some food through. There are lots of nerves around that area. Okay, the whole small bowel, in fact, has got lots of different areas where nerves can be. And of course, these nerves are responsible for innervation of ways of contraction, which move the contents of the small bowel through. So these nerves can get affected through toxins, for example, Campylobacter or Shigella, or there are different toxins that can affect not just the nerves, but also cells lining the valve. Okay, there are even what we call cytolethal sort of toxins produced by some of these not so good bacteria that can sort of partially paralyze or render this valve impotent, I should say, where the valve's not really working properly. Many, many patients over years I have seen have got ileocecal valve issues, right? So the ileocecal valve can be fixed up. So if you've got really bad gut issues and a lot of pain in this area or tenderness in that area, my other question to you would be, would you have also perhaps pain or tenderness in the lower back or somewhere on the right side of your body? Okay, internally, you might feeling some sort of like pushing pains or griping pains or stabbing pains or shooting pains. These could be linked up in part to the valve, being dysfunctional. Many people have got lots of gas, for example, produced in the small bowel. And this gas, okay, can also have components which can really affect that valve bad. So a smart thing for you to do, of course, as per usual, is to do a stool test to discover what kind of bacteria or yeasts or parasites you've got in your gut that could be affecting the functionality of this valve. So that makes a lot of sense to do that. In fact, I've been working with a patient who now is finally clear with a very major parasitic problem of the gut, which we've got rid of, and her major symptom was tremendous pain around the ileocecal valve. So a good thing for you to do yourself is to spend some time, put a bit of attention towards that valve. You can massage that valve. You can make up a nice hot pack with castor oil and put that on that area, warm it up, and then do some, nice abdominal massage. Or you could also see a chiropractor who's very skilled in that area. You may well know an osteopath or chiropractor, that you can work with, and ask he or she if she can work with the ileocecal valve. And many practitioners can, where they can just gently manipulate that valve and make it work so much better. It can make the world of difference for your abdominal comfort, especially if you get a lot of gas and cramping pains. But remember, stool testing to discover if there's any bugs that need cleaning up. Second thing is go and see someone with some skill set with the ileocecal valve, or look at some more YouTube videos out there. You'll find some on how to manipulate this valve, massage it. Because there are different ways and means that you can get that valve feeling a lot better. Because you don't have to live with that much discomfort at all in that region, okay? Don't be afraid to use these things and touch your own body when you need to do that in these areas. Because it could make the difference between having a nice comfortable night's sleep and not so much pain versus being up all night, and having a terrible sleep. So there you have it, ileocecal valve dysfunction. Thanks for tuning in. Click on the link in the description box if you want my free paper. Thank you.